Hi everyone, this is Brandon here. So I'm on my sub account, my noob. I just want to show you guys some of my defense log. Some of you guys have been asking to show the defense log as to how bad the defenses are. So if we scroll the way to the bottom, you can see the second last one is minus 59 trophies and stealing basically all my resources. Most of the time I get 100%. So as you can see, this particular one done by Adam is 600,000 gold. Losing 18 trophies, and some of them were quite bad, like this one also 500,000, and also 2,437 dark elixir. So this one two in a row, 500,000 gold, and I don't really stock up that much elixir because I will usually spend them, but when I have a lot of elixir, of course they also get stolen. Usually I use my elixir to cook wizards and to stock up on troops so that I can donate to my clanmates. So as you can see, this one is also 600,000. So we will watch one of them just to let you guys get a feel of how it is to be able to find such a high loot and also get raided by other people. So as you can see, people just basically just drop one archer around the whole entire base and just to get a bit of the resources for now. So eventually my cannon, my level 1 cannon started to defend a bit, taking out maybe 2 or 3 of the barbarians, now targeting the archer queen. So as you can see, the cannon has just gone down by the damage of the archer queen. So basically this base is totally destroyed. So just taking all my resources, but I'm fine with people taking my gold because I do not need gold, that's one. As for elixir, of course I still need elixir and dark elixir, that's why I'm still farming for both of them. So we will now look at my attack log as to how have I been pushing my trophies. As I've mentioned, I want to push back to masters to farm over there. So I've been sniping quite a few of the town halls and also did a few raids. So another town hall snipes. So we will watch one of this attack I've been doing. I've been using BAM, which is Barbarian, Archers and Minions. So just a little tip for you guys, in order to determine how where the loot is actually distributed. If you look at the gold mine and the elixir collector, they are kind of full if you look at the crate over there. If you zoom in to see the gold, the pile of gold over there. So as for dark elixir, it will be that small little square container on top of the drill itself. That's how to determine the level of the resources inside the collectors. Whereas as you can see, the storages, they are like very, very empty. You can see also the dark elixir is also empty. So these are just small little tips that I'll probably add on along the way. I will be making a farming guide for you guys soon. Hopefully I'll be able to get it done soon as possible. So we just proceed on into the raid. So deploying my troops in a particular manner. Playing on my iPad is really easy to deploy with 4 fingers. So deploying troops really fast on the iPad, and using BAM, you have to deploy your troops really fast. Otherwise your troops will just get taken out by those defenses really, really quickly, and you can't really do much damage to the base. So it's important to be able to deploy your troops really quickly so that you can get the maximum damage possible output. But of course, you have to watch out for giant bombs, as if you deploy everything way too fast and then the giant bomb comes and everything just gets killed. So as you can see, the gold and the pumps, they are pretty full on this particular base. Knowing that the resources are all in the collectors, I decided to go for it. They are not in the storages, not much in the storages to be exact. So as you can see, deploying my BAM as the usual strategy, which is my 4 fingers around the whole entire base. I don't usually circle around the whole base because first of all, it is too slow, and second of all, I don't feel that I'm in control of deploying my troops that well. For this particular way of deploying, I feel that it's faster, that's one. And also the defenses will have a harder time to try to take out my troops. So we'll watch a third one that I'd like to show you guys. This one I use my queen. It's a premature town hall 10. As you can see, defenses are all clumped in the middle. So if we look at the storage, the collectors, you can see they are pretty full. So I know that the collectors are collecting the resources, the ones having the resources. But if we look at the storages, they are pretty empty. But if you look at that particular gold storage, the level 1 or level 2 gold storage is pretty full. But the high level gold storages, they are pretty empty. So I know that most of the resources are basically in the collectors. So taking out the collectors with my just archers, just a few archers. Just a thing to note, which is you don't have to use all your troops to go for all the raids, but of course this particular one was quite tough because I didn't bring wall breakers with me. So I had to break through the wall with the troops that I have. So luckily I had 5 wizards in my clan castle thanks to my clanmates. They gave me that really, really nice of them. So now I just drop my queen to take out the dark elixir drill to take out more, to take more dark elixir. So I'll just show you guys one example of what I mean by the resources in the storages and resources in the collector. So this space I went to snipe the town hall. As you can see, the town hall is slightly exposed at the bottom. But now if we look at the storage, the dark elixir storage, it's very, very full. So now you know that the 400,000 on the left, is top left, as you can see, although it's 400,000, but it's not in the collectors, it's in the storages. So of course I won't go for this base because it'll be really, really tough for me to use my BAM to go for this base. I'll probably maybe even get only one storage, the most get two if I'm lucky enough. The infernos do not take my troops out really, really quickly. But if you look at the dark elixir storage also, it's like around 20% full or 40% full. So the drills are pretty empty. So that's just small little tips that I'll give you guys along the way as mentioned. And also do stay tuned for my probably next few videos. I'll make a farming video as to show you guys how I farm in the most optimum way manner. This is just part of it, and hopefully be able to give you guys more farming tips so that you guys can improve your farming too. So with that said, I would like to wrap up my this video, and hopefully you guys can learn something from this video and also improve your farming a bit. Do stay tuned for the full guide on my farming, and definitely I'll make it soon. So thank you for watching my video, and clash on.